Hello viewers, you are welcome to RK Educare, an exclusive educational YouTube channel. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and hit notification bell for forthcoming videos. Dear children, it is very difficult to recall all the chapters of biology when the syllabus is finished. During the time of examination also, you will be tensed to revise every subject. Keeping this in view, your favorite RK Educare YouTube channel created this video in question answer format to revise in a very less time. And touching each and every point from the textbook, there will be no tension at all at the time of examination. This video can be used in digital classrooms to revise biology. Now let us enter into the subject. In biology, the first chapter is nutrition, food supplying system. What is biology? Biology is the study of living organisms and their surroundings. What are living things? The things which have life and perform life processes like growth, respiration, reproduction, excretion, etc. are called living organisms or living things. What are the basic living organisms on this earth? Plants, animals and microorganisms are the basic living organisms on this earth. Who is known as father of biology? Aristotle is known as father of biology. Who used the word biology for the first time? Jean Lamarck used the word biology for the first time. Which language the word biology derived from? The word biology derived from Greek language. What are the root words for biology? Bios and logos are the root words for biology. Bios means life and logos means study of or the science of. What are the major subjects come under biology? Botany, zoology, microbiology and their sub-branches come under biology. What are nutrients? Our body requires some chemical substances for its growth and repair. Such substances are called nutrients. There are 5 kinds of nutrients available. They are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Along with these, our body also requires water and roughages. How are nutrients classified? What are they? Nutrients are classified as micro and macronutrients. What are macronutrients? Some nutrients are required in larger quantities for the bodily activities. They are called macronutrients. Carbohydrates and proteins, fats are macronutrients. What are micronutrients? Some nutrients are required in lesser quantities for the bodily activities. They are called micronutrients. Vitamins and minerals are micronutrients. What is meant by nutrition? Procurement of nutrients into the body of an organism is called nutrition. What are the basic types of nutrition? Autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition are the basic types of nutrition. Along with these two, we can also see symbiotic nutrition also. What is the autotrophic nutrition? Some organisms are capable of synthesizing their own food materials from natural sources like sunlight, water, etc. is called autotrophic nutrition. Give example for autotrophs. All the green plants, phytoplankton, photosynthetic bacteria, algae, etc. are the example for autotrophs. What is heterotrophic nutrition? Some organisms are unable to prepare their own food materials. They either directly or indirectly depend on other animals or plants for their food needs. Such organisms are known as heterotrophs, and this type of nutrition is called heterotrophic nutrition. Give example for heterotrophic nutrition. All the animals, parasites, etc. are the example for heterotrophic nutrition. How do autotrophs prepare their food? Autotrophs prepare their own food materials by a process called photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process by which plants containing green pigment chlorophyll build up complex organic molecules from relatively simple inorganic ones using sunlight as a source of energy. Who proposed an equation for photosynthesis? C.B. Van Liel proposed an equation for photosynthesis in the year 1931. What is the opinion of C.B. Van Liel regarding photosynthesis? C.B. Van Liel expected that for the each molecule of carbohydrate formed, one molecule of water and one molecule of oxygen is produced. What is the simplified equation for photosynthesis? CO2 plus 2H2O gives rise in presence of sunlight, and chlorophyll CH2O plus H2O plus O2 are produced. What is the balanced equation for photosynthesis? 6CO2 plus 2LH2O in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. C6H12O6 plus 6H2O plus 6O2. What is the chemical formula of glucose? C6H12O6 is the chemical formula of glucose. On which organism C.B. Van Hill worked to show that light plays a specific role on photosynthesis? C.B. Van Hill worked on purple sulfur bacteria to show that light plays a special role on photosynthesis. On purple sulfur bacteria, what did C.B. Van Hill use instead of water? Instead of water, C.B. Van Hill used on purple sulfur bacteria hydrogen sulfide or H2S. What are the simpler products among carbohydrates and cellulose? Carbohydrates are the simpler products than cellulose. What are the raw materials used in photosynthesis? Carbon dioxide, water, light, and chlorophyll are the raw materials used in photosynthesis. What are the end products of photosynthesis? Glucose, oxygen, and water are the end products of photosynthesis. Who discovered oxygen? Joseph Priestley discovered oxygen in the year 1774. Who named oxygen? Levasseur named oxygen in the year 1775. Which experiment shows that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis? Mohl's off-leaf experiment shows that carbon dioxide is necessary for photosynthesis. Which chemical is used in Mohl's off-leaf experiment? Potassium hydroxide is used in Mohl's off-leaf experiment. What is the role of KOH in Mohl's off-leaf experiment? KOH or potassium hydroxide absorbs all the carbon dioxide from the glass bottle. Who experimentally showed the formation of oxygen in plants? John Ingenhouse in the year 1779 showed experimentally the formation of oxygen in plants. Who detected the point of maximum rate of photosynthesis in plants? Engelmann detected the point of maximum rate of photosynthesis in plants. Which experiment shows that light is necessary for photosynthesis? Light screen experiment or block paper experiment shows that light is necessary for photosynthesis. Who isolated and named chlorophyll? Pelletier and Caventou isolated and named chlorophyll. What is the site of photosynthesis? Chloroplast is the site of photosynthesis. What is John Ingenhouse experiment? Hydrilla funnel experiment is John Ingenhouse experiment. What is meant by chlorophyll? Chlorophyll means green leaf. Who observed that chlorophyll does not spread all over the cell? Julius Van Sachs in the year 1883 observed that chlorophyll does not spread all over the cell. Where is chlorophyll located in a plant cell? Chlorophyll is located in a plant cell in chloroplast. Where do more number of chloroplasts are available in a plant cell? More number of chloroplasts are available in stomatal guard cells and ground tissue of the plants. How many membranes are there in chloroplast? There are 3 membranes in chloroplast. What is granum? Granum is a third membrane which is stacked and sac-like structure. What is stroma? Stroma is an intermediate fluid present in chloroplast. Where do enzymatic reactions take place in chloroplast? Enzymatic reactions takes place in stroma of the chloroplast. What are the photosynthetic pigment? Substances found in chloroplast which capture sunlight are called photosynthetic pigments. What is the central molecule of chlorophyll? Magnesium is the central molecule of chlorophyll. What is the basic difference between chlorophyll and hemoglobin? In chlorophyll, central molecule is magnesium, whereas iron is the central molecule in Hemoglobin. What are the two major kinds of chloroplasts associated with thylakoid membranes? There are two kinds of chlorophylls associated with thylakoid membranes. They are chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. What is the major difference between chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B? Chlorophyll A is blue green in color, chlorophyll B is yellow green in color. How is light harvesting complex or photosynthetic unit formed in each granum? Around 250 to 400 pigment molecules are grouped as a light harvesting complex or photosynthetic unit. What are the three major events occur in chloroplasts? Conversion of light energy to chemical energy, splitting of water molecule, reduction of carbon dioxide to carbohydrates. These are three major events occur in chloroplasts. Where do light reactions take place in chloroplast? Light reactions take place in granum of the chloroplast. Where do light independent or dark reactions take place in chloroplast? Dark reactions or light independent reactions take place in stroma of the chloroplast. What is the other name of light reactions? Photosynthetic phase is the other name of light reactions. What is the other name of dark reactions? Biosynthetic phase is the other name of dark reactions. What is photon? Photon is the smallest unit of light. What are called assimilatory powers? ATP and NADPH are called assimilatory powers. What are the end products of light reaction? ATP and NADPH are the end products of light reactions. Expand ATP. ATP stands for adenosine triphosphate. Expand NADPH. NADPH stands for nicotinamide adenosine dinucleotide hydrogen phosphate. How is glucose converted in chloroplast? Glucose is converted to starch, which is hardly soluble. It occurs in chloroplast. What is saprophytic nutrition? Some organisms break down the food materials outside their bodies and absorb it. Such type of organisms are called saprophytes, and this kind of nutrition is called saprophytic nutrition. Give example for saprophytic nutrition. Bread molds, yeast, mushrooms, etc. are example for saprophytic nutrition. What is parasitic nutrition? Some organisms live in the bodies of other organisms to obtain their food. Such organisms are called parasites. This type of nutrition is called parasitic nutrition. Give example for parasitic nutrition. Cascuta, lice, leeches and tapeworms, etc. are example for parasitic nutrition. What are the finger-like extensions or locomotory organs present in amoeba? Pseudopodia or finger-like extensions or locomotory organs of amoeba. What mode of nutrition can be seen in amoeba and paramecium? Diffusion is common mode of nutrition in most of the unicellular organisms like amoeba and paramecium. What type of nutrition can be seen in most of the unicellular organisms? Diffusion is more common type of nutrition in unicellular organisms. Give an example for parasitic plants. Dodder or Cascuta is good example for parasitic plants. Which family dodder belong to? Dodder belongs to Convolvulaceae or Morning Glory family. Why is dodder a parasitic plant? Dodder is a parasitic plant because it has no chlorophyll. How many species genus Cascuta contain? Genus Cascuta contain about 170 species distributed throughout temperate and tropical regions. Name one species which contain very small amount of chlorophyll in genus Cascuta. In genus Cascuta, Cascuta reflexa contain very low amount of chlorophyll. What do we call the organism which gives shelter to the parasite? An organism which gives shelter to the parasite is called host. How do dodder plants absorb food and water from the host? Dodder plants absorb food and water from the host plant by root like structures called haustoria. How is the stem of dodder? The stem of dodder is slender and string like. The stem is yellow, orange, pink or brown in color. How are the leaves of dodder? The leaves of dodder are reduced to minute scales. How are petals of dodder? The dodder's flowers are nodule like clusters, are made up of tiny yellow or white bell like petals. What is the outermost membrane which cover the leaf when we observe transverse section of leaf? Cuticle is outermost membrane which covers the leaf when we observe transverse section of leaf. What is the layer that lies below the cuticle in transverse section of leaf? Upper epidermis towards upper side, lower epidermis towards lower side, or the layers which are below the cuticle of leaf when we observe transverse section. Where does photosynthesis take place? Photosynthesis takes place in chloroplast of the plant cell. What is the tissue which supply water to the entire body of a plant? Xylem tissue supplies water to entire body of a plant. Which tissue serves food to all the plant's body? Phloem tissue serves food to all the organs of the plant's body. What are the openings of gaseous exchange on the leaf? Stomata are the openings of gaseous exchange on the leaf. How are stomata protected? Stomata is protected by two kidney-shaped guard cells. Where is air accumulated when it enters through stomata? When air enters through stomata, air is stored at air spaces. Who traps sunlight in a plant's body? Chlorophyll traps sunlight among plants. What are the two kinds of parenchyma tissue found in transverse section of leaf? Palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma are two kinds of parenchyma tissue found in transverse section of leaf. Describe palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. Palisade parenchyma is regularly arranged tissue. Spongy parenchyma is irregularly arranged tissue, which are found between upper and lower epidermis. What is digestion? Breaking down of complex food materials into simple substances with the help of enzymes and absorbed into the body is called digestion. What is the function of teeth in human digestion? Teeth cut and crush the food in the mouth. Why does the food come slippery in the mouth? Food becomes slippery in the mouth because of addition of saliva. What are responsible for the production of saliva? Salivary glands are responsible for the production of saliva. How many types of salivary glands are there in human body? What are they? There are three types of salivary glands in human body: sublingual, submaxillary and parotid glands. What is the location of salivary glands in human body? Two pairs are located at the side of the jaw and one pair is below the tongue. What are the two kinds of glands in human body? There are two kinds of glands in human body: endocrine glands and exocrine glands. Endocrine glands are ductless glands which secrete hormones directly into blood. Exocrine glands are ducted glands which secrete enzymes. To which category salivary glands belong? Salivary glands are belong to exocrine glands. Which enzyme is secreted by salivary glands? Salivary glands secrete ptyalin or salivary amylase. What is the function of salivary amylase or ptyalin in human digestion? Ptyalin acts on carbohydrates and produces maltose. What are the major cavities of human body? There are three major cavities present in human body: buccal cavity or oral cavity, chest cavity or thoracic cavity, and the third abdominal cavity. What is the opening of human digestion? Mouth is the opening of human digestion. What is the function of salivary amylase or ptyalin in human digestion? Ptyalin acts on carbohydrates and produce maltose. What are the oral organs and their function in human digestion? Teeth, tongue, jaws are oral organs. Teeth helps in cutting and crushing the food or chewing. Tongue helps in mixing the food and pushing it to the next organ. Jaws are the supporting organs in these processes. What is peristalsis? The wave-like movement of food from one organ to the next of human digestion is called peristalsis. What is esophagus? What is its function? Esophagus is a pipe-like structure which connects mouth and stomach. It does nothing in digestion, but the soft walls of esophagus allow the food to stomach by peristaltic way. Describe stomach and mention its function. Stomach is a soft bag-like structure which churns the food by its stronger walls. It releases gastric juice by gastric glands which contain hydrochloric acid to kill unwanted germs present in the food. Here, proteins are converted to peptones by an enzyme called pepsin. Here, the food is called chyme. What is chyme? Soft and slimy food present in the stomach which contain already broken carbohydrates and proteins is called chyme. What are sphincters? Sphincters are valve-like structures which allow the passage of food from one organ to the next only in smaller quantities. How is food passed from stomach to small intestine? The passage of food from stomach to small intestine is regulated by pyloric sphincter. When pyloric sphincter is relaxed, smaller quantities of food is allowed to enter into small intestine. What do we call entire human digestive system commonly? Entire human digestive system commonly known as alimentary canal. What is the length of alimentary canal in human body? It is about 9 meters in general. What is the longest part of alimentary canal? Small intestine is the longest part of alimentary canal. Its length is about 6 meters in general. Where is the most food is digested? Most of the food is digested in small intestine. What happens to the food in small intestine? Maximum digestion of carbohydrates, proteins and fats takes place in small intestine. Small intestine receives bile juice from liver and pancreatic juice from pancreas, and food gradually changes to alkaline or basic. What is duodenum? The first part of small intestine, which is usually U-shaped structure, is called duodenum. It is a connection between stomach and small intestine. What are the digestive juices secreted into duodenum? Bile juice and pancreatic juice are the juices secreted into duodenum. Bile juice is secreted by liver, pancreatic juice is secreted by pancreas. What does bile juice contain? Bile juice contains bile pigments called bilirubin, biliverdin, and urochrome. What is emulsification? Fats are digested and converted to small globule-like forms by the action of bile juice, which is secreted by liver, called emulsification. Which digestive juice does not contain any enzyme? Bile juice has no enzymes. What are the enzymes that are secreted by pancreas? Pancreas secretes enzymes like amylase, trypsin, and lipase. What is the role of pancreas in human digestion? Pancreas releases pancreatic juice which contain enzymes called amylase, trypsin and lipase. Amylase acts on carbohydrates and convert them into maltose. Trypsin acts on proteins and convert them into peptones. Lipase acts on fats and convert them into fatty acids and glycerol. All these enzymes are secreted into duodenum. What is the digestive juice which is secreted by small intestine? Intestinal juice or succinetricus is the digestive juice secreted by small intestine. What are the end products of fats? Amino acids are the end products of fats. What are the four different stages through which human digestion occurs? Human digestion occurs in four different stages. They are ingestion, digestion, absorption and defecation. What is ingestion? Taking food into the body through mouth is called ingestion. What is digestion? Breaking down of food materials into simpler forms by enzymes is called digestion. What is absorption? Passage of digested food through the walls of alimentary canal, particularly into small intestine, to circulatory system is called absorption. Actually, after the food is digested, it is absorbed into blood by the walls of small intestine. What is defecation? The passage of undigested material from body by the way of anus is called defecation. How is digested food absorbed into the blood? Walls of small intestine has large number of finger-like projections called microvilli. The villi increases the surface area of absorption of digested food through a network called blood vessels and lymph vessels. So, by the lymph vessels and blood vessels, all the useful food is taken into the blood. What is the role of large intestine in human digestion? After the completion of absorption in small intestine, all the useful substances in the food are transported to the blood and lymph. The rest of it passes to the large intestine, which is undigested and has large quantities of water. The water is absorbed through the walls of large intestine. The basic function of large intestine is to absorb water. What is the length of large intestine in adults? It is 1.5 meter in general. What is fecal matter? Undigested waste which is sent to the rectum and anus for a defecation is called fecal matter. What does fecal matter contain? Fecal matter contains considerable amount of proteins, fats, carbohydrates, roughages or fibers of either carbohydrates or proteins. What are the causes of vomiting? There are many reasons for vomiting. The main cause is overeating. High proportion of fat in the food, taking indigestible or poisonous food. What is greenish vomiting and mention the reason for this? When we have a greenish vomit, it is usually called bilious or liverish. We get bitter taste and it is often the result of rich meals over several days. What is the result of liverish vomiting? The liver is unable to cope with the excessive fat and we get a feeling of nausea or dizziness. What are the measures to avoid problems related to digestion? Having simple, well-balanced meals, eating them in a leisurely manner, thoroughly masticating the food, avoiding taking violent exercise soon after eating food, drinking plenty of water and having regular bowel movements are the measures to avoid problems related to digestion. What is the most serious form of indigestion and which type of people may suffer from it? Most serious form of indigestion caused by stomach and duodenal ulcers. This problem can be seen in the people those who are hurried and worried. Those who have a habit of hurrying over meals and rushing from one activity to the other without sufficient rest. How to avoid constipation? Intake of fiber-rich food avoids constipation or indigestion. What is malnutrition? Eating of food that does not have one or more than one nutrients in required amounts is known as malnutrition. What are the reasons for malnutrition? Poor health, willful starvations, lack of awareness of nutritional habits, socio-economic factors, etc. are the reasons for malnutrition. What are the three types of malnutrition? Calorie malnutrition, protein malnutrition, protein calorie malnutrition. Names of malnutrition related diseases. Kwashiorkor, marasmus, obesity are malnutrition related diseases, especially kwashiorkor and marasmus. What is the cause of kwashiorkor disease? Kwashiorkor disease is because of protein deficiency in the diet. What are the symptoms of kwashiorkor? Body parts become swollen due to accumulation of water in the intercellular spaces, very poor muscle development, swollen legs, fluffy face, difficulty to eat, diarrhea, dry skin. These are all symptoms of kwashiorkor. What is the cause of marasmus disease? Marasmus disease is due to deficiency of both proteins and calories in the diet. Generally, this occurs when there is an immediate second pregnancy or repeated childbirths. What are the symptoms of marasmus? The symptoms of marasmus are lean and weak, less developed muscles, dry skin, diarrhea. What is the cause for obesity? Obesity is due to overeating and excess of calories intake, taking junk food. What are the symptoms of obesity? Obese children, when grow, they will be target of many diseases. Diabetes, cardiovascular problems, renal and gallbladder problems also can be seen in the people who are suffering from obesity. What do you know about vitamins? Vitamins are organic substances. They are micronutrients that are required in smaller quantities. Vitamins are not synthesized in the body. However, we do not suffer from vitamin deficiency diseases. How do we obtain vitamins into our body? Diet supplies vitamin to the body. Bacteria present in the intestine and also serve vitamins to the body. How are vitamins classified? Vitamins are classified into two groups: water soluble vitamins and fat soluble vitamins. Vitamin B complex and C are water soluble vitamins. Vitamin A, D, E, K are fat soluble vitamins. How many types of teeth are there? What are they? There are four kinds of teeth in our mouth. They are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. What is dental formula? Arrangement of teeth on upper and lower jaw is called dental formula. Whom do you meet whether you are suffering from teeth problems? We will meet dentist whether we are suffering from dental problems. Whom do you meet whether you are suffering from digestional problems? We have to meet gastroenterologist whether we are suffering from digestional problems. Whom do you meet whether you are suffering from nutrition based diseases? We have to meet a nutritionist whether we are suffering from nutritional based diseases. Name some vitamin deficiency diseases. Beriberi, glossitis, pellagra, anemia, nervous disorders, scurvy, blood clotting, eye skin diseases, rickets, burning feet, fertility disorders. These are some of the deficiency, vitamin deficiency diseases. What do you know about beriberi disease? In beriberi, the deficient vitamin is B1, it is also called thiamine. Vomiting, fits, पैरालिसिस, लॉस ऑफ एपिटाइट, डिफिकल्टी इन ब्रीथिंग आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ बेरीबेरी डिसीज. सेरेल्स, ऑयल सीड्स, मिल्क, वेजिटेबल्स, मीट, फिश एंड एग्स आर द रिसोर्सेस फॉर B1 विटामिन. वॉट डू यू नो अबाउट ग्लॉसेटिस डिसीज? ग्लॉसेटिस डिसीज इज बिकॉज ऑफ डिफिशियंसी ऑफ विटामिन B2. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड राइबोफ्लेविन. माउथ क्रैक्स एट कॉर्नर्स, रेड एंड सोर टंग, फोटोफोबिया, स्केली स्किन आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ ग्लॉसेटिस डिसीज. मिल्क, एग्स, मीट, लिवर, किडनी, ग्रीन लीफी वेजिटेबल्स आर द रिसोर्सेस ऑफ B2 विटामिन. वॉट डू यू नो अबाउट पेलाग्रा डिसीज? पेलाग्रा डिसीज इज बिकॉज ऑफ डिफिशियंसी ऑफ B3 विटामिन. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड नियासिन. डर्मेटाइटिस, डायरिया, स्केली स्किन, लॉस ऑफ मेमोरी आर द सिम्टम्स ऑफ पेलाग्रा डिसीज. मीट, फिश, एग्स, लिवर, किडनी, ऑयल सीड्स आर द रिसोर्सेस ऑफ B3 आर नियासिन विटामिन. वॉट डू यू नो अबाउट एनीमिया डिसीज? एनीमिया डिसीज इज बिकॉज ऑफ deficiency of either B6 or B9 vitamins. Whether B6 or pyridoxine is deficient, hyperirritability, nausea, vomiting, fits are the symptoms. And B6 vitamin is available in cereals, oil seeds, vegetables, milk, meat, fish, eggs, liver, and etc. Whether anemia is because of B9 vitamin, B9 also called folic acid. The symptoms are diarrhea, loss of leukocytes, intestinal mucus problems. Liver, meat, eggs, milk, fruit, cereals, leafy vegetables are resources of B9 vitamin or folic acid. What do you know about pernicious anemia? Pernicious anemia is because of B12 vitamin, that is also called cyanocobalamin. Lean and weak, less appetite are the symptoms of pernicious anemia. This vitamin is synthesized by bacteria present in the intestine. What do you know about burning feet? The disease burning feet is because of deficiency of B5 vitamin, that is also called pantothenic acid. Walking problems, sprains are the symptoms of burning feet disease. Sweet potatoes, groundnuts, vegetables, liver, kidney, eggs are the resources of B5 vitamin or pantothenic acid. What do you know about nervous disorders? Nervous disorders are because of deficiency of vitamin B7, is also called biotin. Fatigue, mental depression, muscle pains are the symptoms of nervous disorders. Pulses, nuts, vegetables, liver, milk, kidney are the resources of B7 vitamin or biotin. What do you know about scurvy disease? Scurvy disease is because of deficiency of C vitamin. It is also called ascorbic acid. Delay in healing of wounds, fracture of bones are common symptoms of scurvy disease. Green leafy vegetables, citrus fruits, sprouts are the resources of C vitamin or ascorbic acid. Mention the causes for eye and skin diseases. Vitamin A deficiency leads to eye and skin diseases. Vitamin A is called retinol. Night blindness, scaly skin, xerophthalmia, cornea failure are the symptoms of this disease. Leafy vegetables, carrot, tomato, pumpkin, papaya, mango, meat, fish, egg, liver, milk, cod liver oil, shark liver oil. These are all resources of vitamin A or retinol. What do you know about Rickett's disease? Rickett's disease is because of deficiency of D vitamin. D vitamin also called calciferol. Improper formation of bones, knock knees, swollen wrists, weak bones, delayed dentition. These are symptoms of Rickett's disease. Liver, egg, butter, cod liver oil, shark liver oil, and morning sun rays are the resources of vitamin D. What do you know about fertility disorders? Fertility disorders are deficiency of vitamin E also called tocopherol. sterility in males, abortions in females are the symptoms of fertility disorders. Fruits, vegetables, sprouts, meat, eggs, sunflower oil are the resources of vitamin E.
Human.